Welcome to 5 Minutes Ago, a show we wrote, well, 5 minutes ago.
To infinity and beyond!
With our hosts, Lincoln Crockett, Michelle Zhang, Sergio Castillo, and Allie Landry. With guest hosts, Erik and Asa Rosenmeier.
Fasten your seatbelts.
Hey everyone, welcome to 5 Minutes Ago.
And a special welcome to our guest host this week, Senior Erik Rosenmeier. Sadly, we don't have Sergio here with us today, but we're lucky that Eric's brother Asa is already a pro and can fill in. And Michelle also made a stand-in David for us.
Clearly, it's a real Rosenmeier month on 5 Minutes Ago. And nobody get mad at us for Asa's double appearance. He was simply at the right place at the right time. But anyways, we learned that Asa makes a pretty solid omelet every morning. So what about you, Erik? Do you have any Rosenmeier quirks?
I do have plenty of quirks. One thing that I can't do that most people can is frown.
That's really tough, Erik. But just for the record, I can frown just like the emoji.
Yeah, and to clarify, it's not genetic.
It's a good thing I won't need to be frowning today because I'm super excited to be hosting and premiering on 5 Minutes Ago. But for now, let's turn to this week's announcements.
Midterm exams will begin on January 25th. You only have to be in school for your exams. Lunch will be available in the cafeteria during the exam break. Breakfast also will be served. Admin will share room numbers soon.
Takeshi and Misaki Tatsumi were recently one of 10 winning teams in the NASA Space Apps Challenge Global Championship. A total of 28,000 students from 162 countries participated in the competition. Misaki and Takeshi are now invited to tour the NASA facilities in Florida and view a spacecraft launch in recognition of their accomplishments.
Just a few safety reminders, outdoor seating options for lunch are available in the cafeteria / commons. Make sure to dress warmly.
Please keep your mask over your nose and mouth when not eating or drinking. Because Omicron spreads so easily, please wear a KN95 mask if possible. Also, spectators at games are limited to 2 guardians per student.
The annual Martin Luther King Jr. breakfast will be virtual this year. Rahsaan Hall, director of the Racial Justice Program at American Civil Liberties Union of Massachusetts, will be the keynote speaker. See the description for the link to sign up.
And now for our sports announcements.
Senior Liam Mitchell recently set 2 school records in the swim team's meet against Arlington and Watertown. He swam the 50-meter freestyle in 22.6 seconds and the 100-meter breaststroke in 1 minute and 1.26 seconds. Way to go, Liam, and best of luck to the swim team throughout their season. To check out this week's schedule, see the description and our Instagram page. And now for our arts announcements.
The band, chorus, and orchestra programs will be hosting an 8th grade step-up event after school on Wednesday, January 19th. The 8th grade music students will take a tour of the performing arts wing and have a chance to play in side-by-side rehearsals with the high school ensembles. The Trium Music Honor Society will be helping as volunteers to run the event as we welcome our future musicians to VHS.
This week, we have a brand new segment called Game Show in the Hall, which includes our very special guest host, Erik.
It's time for everyone's favorite game show in the hall, Get a Clue, where 2 teams battle out in a war of words. The rules are simple. A clue giver needs to get their teammate to say a word without saying the answer, using rhyming clues or spelling of any way. For our first team, we have Lot Bates, who loves to drink full glasses of milk, and his partner, Tony Zhao, who guest hosted 5 minutes ago and retired to be a pro game show contestant. For our second team, we have Lydia Haddad, who read 72 books over lockdown, and her friend Irene Sun, who passionately overused emojis over Gmail in the 5th grade. Alright Lot, you have 30 seconds to get Tony to say as many words as possible. Ready? Go!
A tool you bang nails with.
Hammer.
Okay, I'm wearing what?
Pants? Shoes? Clothes?
On my foot.
Shoe? Socks? Yeah.
First one was correct. I walk on the floor, but it's too cold, so what do I put on the floor?
Socks. Carpet.
What's another word for carpet?
Blanket. Rug. Rug.
Rug. What am I reading? What did Lydia read?
A book?
Yes. What do I used to write?
Time's up! Good job, guys. Do you guys think you guys won?
I think that's a solid performance.
I am not sure. We'll see.
Alright, Irene. You have 30 seconds on the clock. Ready? Go!
Not a cat.
Dog.
Has 2 wheels.
Car. Bike.
You eat this. It's triangular. Pepperoni.
A circle.
Pizza.
Pizza. Our principal.
Isaac Taylor.
You walk on this on the side of the street.
Sidewalk.
Not a pencil.
Pen.
You drink this in the morning.
Milk. Juice.
Brown.
Apple juice. Coffee. Tea.
And coffee. Fruit. Red.
That's time. Great job, guys. I gotta say, that was a pretty intense game. Can I please get a drum roll? With the winning score of 8, the prize goes to Lydia and Irene!
Hey!
Congratulations, you guys just won a brand new... Wait a minute, where's the prize guy?
Sorry, I'm late, everyone. Can I just see this pen for a second? Thanks, man. All right, here's your number one half-drank Diet Coke. I have some more prizes to handle out. I'll see you guys later.
Yay! Thank you! Thank you.
Several weeks ago, we asked you if you would rather have a pet dragon or a pet dinosaur, and we got some great responses. Here are the top three.
At number three, it's a little bit more interesting to say that my dragon burnt my homework to a crisp.
At number two, I like dino chicken nuggets too much to have a dinosaur.
And at number one, we have Mr. Moresco's son says, dinosaur because dragon would burn down the house and then you would have to call the firemen. And the winner, with a whopping 90%, was dragons.
This week, we want to know if you prefer to have a snow day or one less school day at the end of the year.
What do you think, Eric?
Well, it doesn't really matter to me. I'm in senior slide mode, so every day's a day off.
I would say snow days, but now that Eric's a senior, I want him to go to school as much as possible, so no snow days.
Thanks for stopping by, Eric, and thanks for coming back, Asa.
I've had a great time.
And we'll see you in 2 weeks, since Martin Luther King Jr. Day is next Monday. Bye.
Bye. Make sure to follow us on Instagram at 5minutesago_VHS. Also, hit the QR code on screen to find the question of the week.
You mean you can't frown?
You can't frown? That's so endearing, Eric.
Really weird.
Using rhymes and clues and you cannot use us.
Ugh, she's like 25 pounds.
We have Lot Bates, who is loves to drink. Okay, we're just gonna.
Lincoln! I'm on his walk home route, and he always sings, like, loudly.
Now she's looking at the screen!
yeah, because I heard you go by and you were singing.
Oh, yeah, I do that. It's because I was biking, yeah.
You were biking. You got a little helmet head right there.
Yeah.
And can I please get a drum roll? The final score was 8. Congratulations to.
Is everybody else ready?
Give me 1 second. I'm just trying to tape this on my desk.
All right, guys.
You can't frown.
Nope.